Thank you and welcome to the show today. The topic this morning is Laura B. McCrae, A Personal Profile. And we hesitated simply because that is the only thing that we have in this topic this morning, Laura B. McCrae, A Personal Profile. And of course, we have with us this morning to talk about Laura B. McCrae herself. And Ms. McCrae, let me welcome you to the show this morning and tell you how extremely delighted we are to have you with us this morning to talk about some of the experiences and some of the things that have been important in your 89 years in terms of leading you where we are today. And so let's start off by having you in your own way to give us some information about your background, your education, and some of the things that have been important in your life, and then we'll get into some other aspects of your experiences, your life experiences, your early childhood, and et cetera. But let's start off by having you to give us that kind of information.
Well, Dr. Haney, it's a joy to be with you this morning and to share with you some of my experiences. It happens that my father, and often when I'm asked about my background, and I think I always open with my parents because my parents influenced me so very much in all areas of my life. Mm-hmm. And my daddy's name was William T. Creighton, mm-hmm. C-R-A-Y-T-O-N. My mother was Lillian. It happens that my mother is a Pennsylvanian and my father an Alabamian. Mm-hmm. It happened that my dad was discovered with very soft hands, mm-hmm. and was recommended to go to Battle Creek, Michigan, and was trained as a physiotherapist, and became an outstanding physiotherapist. And he, during his internship, he did that in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and attended the Mount Zion Baptist Church, and met my mother. And they were married in 1906 in Battle Creek. I was born 1908, Battle Creek, Michigan. Mm-hmm. And it happens that recently I was taken to Battle Creek to visit my birthplace because I had always wanted to visit Battle Creek. And I found that my father was listed as a registered nurse in the sanatorium called the Sand there, under Dr. Kellogg.
And I know that you were really impressed and encouraged by that.
I was encouraged. Mm-hmm. And I thought, though, from the beginning that he was there like 4 years in college. Mm-hmm. But in checking the record, my father was there 11 years in training and in work at Battle Creek under Dr. Kellogg.
You know, when you talk about that period in American history or in world history, a lot of folks, we've moved so far beyond that. Mm-hmm. A lot of folks really don't understand and have very few ideas about what life must have been like during that period. Well, what about your early childhood? Tell us something about some of the experiences and some of the things that you became involved with at an early period.
It just happens that as my father was ending his training at Battle Creek, Booker T. Washington, the founder of Tuskegee University, needed someone to travel with him, and my father was the one chosen to do that.
To travel with Mr. Washington?
Yes, Booker T. And so he was called to Tuskegee to be the traveling nurse with Booker T. Washington.
Have you ever had an opportunity to meet Mr. Booker T. Washington?
Well, you know, I must have, but I was so young because Booker T. died in 1915, and I don't remember him. But I do remember because I went to kindergarten in his buggy, and the person who drove me to kindergarten was a Mr. Foster. Mr. Foster is Lionel Richie's grandfather at Tuskegee. So I remember Mr. Foster, and I remember the white horse, and I remember the buggy. But I don't remember that I ever met
Mrs. Booker T. Washington, but undoubtedly you did just by the very association that your father had with Mr. Washington during that period.
Yes.
And so you grew up around Tuskegee, Alabama, around
and Booker T. died in 1915.